Supernovas are some of the most spectacular events in the universe. They are the explosive deaths of massive stars that can outshine entire galaxies. But did you know that these cosmic fireworks also create and spread dust throughout space? Dust that is essential for the formation of new stars, planets, and even life. In this episode, we'll explore how NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has located dust reservoirs in two supernovae, SN2004-ET and SN2017-EAW, and what this means for our understanding of heavy element production and evolution in the universe. Stay tuned for some amazing images and discoveries from Webb. Before we dive into the new discoveries, let's get to know our three supernova stars. A supernova is the final stage of a star that is at least 8 times more massive than our Sun. When such a star runs out of fuel in its core, it can no longer support its own weight and collapses under its own gravity. This triggers a massive explosion that can outshine an entire galaxy for a brief moment. Supernovas are rare events, occurring only once every 50 years or so in a typical galaxy. But they are also very important, because they produce and spread most of the heavy elements that we find in nature, such as iron, gold, and uranium. The first supernova we'll talk about is 2004-ET, which was discovered in 2004 in a galaxy called NGC 6946, about 22 million light-years away from us. This galaxy is also known as the Fireworks Galaxy, because it has hosted 10 supernovas in the last century, more than any other galaxy we know of. 2004-ET was a Type 2 supernova, which means it was caused by the collapse of a single star. The star was estimated to be about 15 times more massive than our Sun, and it exploded with a force equivalent to about 10 octillion nuclear bombs. The second supernova we'll talk about is 2017-EAW, which was discovered in 2017 in the same galaxy as 2004-ET. This was also a Type 2 supernova, but it was caused by a different mechanism. The star that exploded was about 18 times more massive than our Sun, and it had a companion star orbiting around it. The two stars were so close that they exchanged material with each other, creating a thick envelope of gas around the primary star. When the primary star collapsed, the shock wave from the explosion interacted with this envelope, creating a bright and long-lasting display. And the third supernova we'll talk about is the popular 1987A, which was discovered in 1987 in a nearby galaxy called the Large Magellanic Cloud, about 170,000 light-years away from us. This was the closest supernova observed since the invention of the telescope, and it gave us an unprecedented opportunity to study it in detail. 1987A was also a Type 2 supernova, but it had some unique features that puzzled astronomers for decades. The star that exploded was about 20 times more massive than our Sun, and it had a peculiar ring-shaped structure around it, formed by previous eruptions before the final blast. The ring was illuminated by the shock wave from the explosion, creating a stunning cosmic fireworks show. Now that we have introduced our three supernovas, let's see what Webb has revealed about them. Webb is the most powerful space telescope ever built, and it has some amazing capabilities that make it ideal for studying supernovas. Using its infrared vision, Webb has located dust reservoirs in two of our supernovas, 2004-ET and 2017-EAW. Dust is formed by the condensation of heavy elements produced by supernovas, such as carbon, oxygen, silicon, and iron. These tiny particles can then clump together to form larger grains or even pebbles. Dust is essential for the formation of new stars and planets, as well as for the origin of life on Earth. But how much dust is produced by supernovas and how it survives the harsh environment of an explosion are still open questions. Webb has found that both 2004-ET and 2017-EAW have large amounts of dust in their remnants, about 0.1 to 0.3 solar masses each. That's equivalent to about 30 to 90 times the mass of the Earth. This is surprising because previous studies with other telescopes suggested that these supernovas had much less dust, or even none at all. Webb has also found that the dust in these supernovas is very cold, about minus 260 degrees Celsius, which means it is well shielded from the radiation and shock waves of the explosion. This suggests that the dust is either formed very quickly after the explosion, or that it is protected by dense clumps of gas. Webb has also observed the third supernova, 1987A, but has not detected any dust in its remnant. This is consistent with previous studies, which showed that 1987A had very little dust, or that it was destroyed by the shockwave. However, Webb has made another interesting discovery about 1987A. It has detected a new source of infrared emission in the center of the remnant, where the collapsed core of the star should be. This could be a sign of a neutron star, a dense and compact object that is sometimes left behind by a supernova. A neutron star would emit infrared radiation as it cools down over time. If confirmed, this would be the first direct detection of a neutron star from a Type II supernova. Now that we have seen what Webb has discovered about our three supernovas, let's explore some of the implications and questions that arise from this topic. For example, you might be wondering how Webb's discovery of dust in supernovas affects our understanding of the origin of life on Earth. Well, Webb's discovery of dust in supernovas has important implications for our understanding of the origin of life on Earth. Dust is not only essential for the formation of new stars and planets, but also for the delivery of organic molecules and water to planetary surfaces. These molecules and water are the building blocks of life as we know it. Some scientists believe that Earth was seeded with these ingredients by comets and asteroids that originated from dusty regions around supernovas. Webb's discovery shows that supernovas can produce large amounts of dust that can enrich their surroundings with heavy elements and organic molecules. This supports the idea that supernovas are important sources of life's ingredients in the universe. Another question you might have is how Webb compares to other telescopes that have studied supernovas. Well, Webb is not the first telescope to study supernovas, but it is the most advanced one. Other telescopes, such as Hubble, Spitzer, and ALMA, have also observed supernovas in different wavelengths of light, such as visible, ultraviolet, and radio. Each wavelength reveals different aspects of a supernova, such as its shape, temperature, composition, and evolution. Webb complements these observations with its infrared vision, which can penetrate through dust and gas and reveal hidden features that other telescopes miss. Webb can also observe fainter and more distant supernovas than other telescopes, thanks to its large mirror and sensitive instruments. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed learning about the amazing stories of three supernovas that Webb has observed: 2004 ET, 2017 EAW, and 1987 A. We also hope you learned something new about how supernovas create and distribute cosmic dust, and how this dust affects the formation of stars, planets, and life. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more exciting content about space exploration and discoveries. And don't forget to leave a comment below with your thoughts or questions about this topic. Until next time, stay curious and keep exploring.